Welcome back on Math 3. On today's video, we're gonna focus on the double integration. And it's just a small lesson. It's all about the changing of order, which is sometimes called reverse of order. So, what happens if this case is just that there will be some double integration where you won't be able to integrate. But in that case, you may be required to go and reverse your order or to change your order. Let's take an example. Let's say we're given this function. I've already explained how to read and how to integrate a double integration. Okay? And then we said it's all about we have two parts. We have this part, which is according to with respect to x. Therefore, this is gonna be our x2, and then this is gonna be our x1. So we have the two limits of our x. And then we are going to have a look on our second derivative, which is integration, which is respect to y. And therefore, this is going to be our y2 and as well our y1. But every time you have to do your double integration, you have to always go in the process to draw that function. So how do we draw our function? We have our x and y axis, our coordinates. And as you can see, this, which is a y here, x2 is equal to y, okay? And then we have x1 which is equal to 0. So if you come here, you're gonna see that our x is equal to 0, it's going to be somewhere here. So you have your x is equal to 0, okay? And then you have as well your y which is equal to 0. Your y which is equal to 0, this would be our y which is equal to 0. And then you have a y which is equal to 1. Then come here, you say my y is equal to 1. And then you have the function, the limit of x2. You can see that it's equal to y, which basically is going to be an exponential function. So we may have something like this, because when x is equal to y, if y is equal to 1, which means x is going to be equal to what? To 1. It's all about, you put our limit to draw that graph. You start with your coordinates x and y. You start with y2, which is equal to 1. And then you come here and see y is equal to 1. This will be that function. And then you have as well y is equal to 0, which means this blue down here is going to be y is equal to 0. You have x is equal to 0, which means this line here is going to be x is equal to 0. And then we have our x which is equal to y. Therefore, in the case where our y is equal to 1, y is equal to 1, you can see that our x function is going to be equal to what? To 1. So we're going to have this point here. Therefore, you can draw this graph here, and then you can say that this function is a linear function. Okay, so how do we change now our order? In order for us to change our order, it's really simple, because remember, we have a ddx dy, which we see we cannot integrate according to the function, because we have sin x over x. So to do the integration of this, even if you have to use the UV formula, it's going to be long. But what you are going to do is you need to change this order, which means you start with your y and then you end up doing ddx first. Can you see? But what did that mean? To change order is my function, the first integration was ddx, but I changed it to what? Dy, and then the second will be what? Dx. Okay? So now we're gonna do the integration with respect. With respect to y. With respect to y, which means we are going to take our limit in this direction. Can you see? Because the first integration is with respect to y. So we're gonna have this in this function. So with respect to I, what happened? We're gonna have here. Okay? So we're gonna take our limit here, which means it's gonna be from 0 to x. Can you see? Basically, what you come here, you say it's gonna be from 0 to a y. But this function here, it's a y which is equal to x. So therefore, our y is going to be equal to x. So we change a y function to x function. Okay? And then you put your integration. And then you have your dy. Okay? So what will be the second limit of the second integration, which is our ddx, because we changed the order. But remember, ddx is between what? 1 and 0. Okay? So you are coming, you see, 1 and 0. Because our region is under this. So now you can do your integration. Once you've changed the order, you can see that the integration of this function is going to be really easy. And then once you take that, how do you do this? The integration of sine x with respect to y, which all the x function become what? Constant. Therefore, we're going to keep the constant, which is all the x function. And then the integration of a constant become it what? Give us y. And then between the limit of what? X and 0. And then we have our second integration, which is the outer part with respect to x. And then you check your limit. If you check your limit, you can see that this integral, this function, check your limit, you can see that's going to be sine x. X, here we displace with what? The first limit, which is x minus sine x over x 0. This cancel that. Remember, we still have one integration out there. And therefore, we're going to still remain with this as our integration. So now we are going to do the integration of sine x of this function with respect to x, which we know from our formula sheet is going to give us minus cos x between the limit and 1 and 0. And then make sure you put your calculator in the right hand. Therefore, if you check this limit, it's going to be minus cos x. Okay, we replace this one with 1 and then cos of 0. Your calculator is in radian and then your answer is going to be 0.46. So that's how you do. The idea is just to make sure if they give you a specific function whereby you cannot integrate it, you need to change the order. And in order for you to change the order, what do? You need to draw your graph. And as I said, it's all about the information that will be given on the double integration. Already, you can see what will be the region where the two functions have intersection. So this is going to be one example. We're going to have a look on another example, and then that will be all about the double integration. And let's have a look on this question. And I will try to go slow when it comes to draw the graph to sketch that function. Then we can find our region of integration. I will go slow with it so that you can understand. But it's really simple. But the first thing that you are going to notice is that our first integration will be this inner part. And then you can see that it respects to dy. And the second integration, as you can see, it's all about with respect to x. Okay? So let's analyze. If you take this function and then we do the integration with respect to y, what's going to be the function of y? We can see that you have this 4 minus y and then you have this. So you can see that when you take this function and then you have to do the double integration, already the first integration is going to be long, even if you have to use the UV formula. So the easiest way for you to do is to make sure that you just change the order. How do we change the order? And as I said, the first thing, we need to draw our graph. So let's do our graph. And then in order for you to draw out your graph, you need to identify the limit of x and y under this given function. Okay? And my suggestion is for you to take the outer integration first, because that one is going to be easy to draw. And then you can see that if the outer part is all about with respect to x, which means we have a limit of x which is equal to 0, we have a limit of x which is equal to 0, and then we have a limit of x which is equal to 4. So we come in our Cartesian. You have your x, and then you have your y. The first limit we found that was what? X is equal to 0. X is equal to 0 is going to be where? So here is going to be our function x is equal to 0. First thing. X is equal to 4. Then you come here and count what? 1, 2, 3. Then you have how much? 4. And then you're going to put this to be x is equal to 4. Done. And then we go into the inner function. And then you can see that we have a function where y is equal to 0. Okay? What does that mean? We come here, we see that y is equal to 0 is this. So this is going to be our function y is equal to 0. Okay? And then we have another function whereby y is equal to 4. Can you see? The first one limit was y is equal to 0. And the second limit is going to be y is equal to 4 minus x. Okay? And therefore, after having the two limits of y, we have drawn already y is equal to 0. When it comes to y is equal to this function, now we have to say, let's say when x is equal to 0, what's going to be the function of y here? So we're going to have y is going to be equal to 4 minus 0 squared. Therefore, y is going to be equal to 4. And then automatically, we're going to see that when x is equal to 0, y is going to be equal also to 4. Then you say 1, 2, 3, 4. Then you see it's going to be y is going to be equal to 4. Okay? But our function y is equal to 4 minus x is going to be a linear function. It's going to grow like this. So here we have y is going to be equal to 4 minus x squared. Okay? So, as I was explaining, we start with the outer part because their limits are easy to draw and you understand already how to do it. You take the inner part, but you start with the one that is equal to 0 or any number, any variable, and then you can draw it easily. And then when it comes to the function, as you can see, I put the function down and then I take when x is equal to 0 to check what should be the integration of this function. So I substitute my 0 into this function, then I get 4, which means I'm gonna have a 4 which is equal to y. But basically I have this point, so I can see that our function is gonna be a linear function. And then from there we say this is our y is equal to 4 minus x squared. Now, because we want to change the order, remember it was dy, which means we want to have a with respect to x, which means this function here is going to be a function of x. And then to make it a function of x, it's simple. You play with your mathematics, so you're going to have a 4 plus y, a minus y, under the square root. Okay? And as I said, our first order it was this, which was y is equal to 0 and then y is equal to the given function. But to change the order, as you can see, this one is in the y axis, but we want to take this one and put it in the x axis so that this is going to be our limit. Okay, so once you put it in the x axis, what happens is that this, your first, it's going to be x is equal to what? To 0. Then you say x is equal to 0. Okay? And then the function there is going to be what? X is equal to, as we change this function to this form. So then change is going to be 4 minus y. And therefore you have your x, the given function that we have to integrate. Okay? And then we have now it's ddx. We change the order. From the first integration dy to the first integration ddx. And then the outer part, which is going to be the limit of y, because now we're going to have it as y. And the limit of our y is going to be what? It's going to be 0 and 4. 0 and 4. So once you have changed your order, now you can start doing your calculation. And then you can see that once you change the order, to integrate the function, it becomes easy. Because remember, we are doing integration for the inner part with respect to x, which means everything that has to do with y become a constant. So we keep those constants aside. Okay? And then you see that we remain with a x function. What is the integration of x? It's going to be x squared over 2. Okay? And then once you have that, between the limit of what? 4 minus y and 0. And the second integration, which is going to be 4, 0, d, dy. So we check the limit. So you can see that it's going to be the limit of this minus this. Already the 0, we're going to ignore it. So we're going to have 2y over 4 minus y times. Here you're going to have a square root of 4 minus squared over 2 minus, here because of the 0, we're going to have 0. That will be our limit. And then we keep our second integration. Okay? And then now, if you look very well here, you're going to see that this power 2 will cancel. We cancel that. And then in here, you're going to see that you have 4 minus 4 minus y. So you're going to have something like this. 4 minus y. Okay? And then when this cancel that, and you see, and automatically this will cancel that, and then you're just going to remain with this as your function. And then when you come here, so you're going to have a 2 here, and then with respect to y. Can you see how when you change the order, you can integrate it? And then once you have to integrate this, we know that we keep the constant. The integration of this gives us what? 1 over the derivative of that function. And the derivative of this function gives us what? 2. Okay? Exponential of 2y between the limit of 4 and 0. Okay? And then now we're going to have what? 1 over 4, exponential of 2y, 4 and 0. We check the limit. We have 1 over 4 of exponential 2 times 4, 2 times 4, which give us how much? 8, huh? Minus exponential of what? 2 times 0, which give us how much? 0. Exponential of 0 give us what? 1. And that it. So every time you have to do your integration, and then you come across an integral where you cannot integrate it because it's really difficult, you need to change the order. And to change the order, as I said, it's all about, you start by drawing, to sketch the graph. After sketching your graph, then you can be able to change the order because you know what is the region of that integral. Okay?